to you, and how do you do? Good morning, good morning, good morning to you.
This is Miss Sophie from the Bellwood Library. Remember me?
I'm still missing you, and you, and you, and you, and you too.
Miss Sophie wants to tell you a wonderful story today. There's so many different ways you can tell a story. You can tell a story by looking at pictures in a book, or you can tell a story by listening to music. Remember how we do a hi-ya, hi-ya, hi-ya? Remember that story that we tell? You can do it by making things, like I made the butterflies and told a story. There's so many great ways to tell a story. So Miss Sophie thought of this story years ago, and I said, oh, I have to tell them this story. It is the perfect time to tell them this story. And I want you, while I'm telling the story, to use your imagination. I want you to think about what the little girl looked like. I want you to think about all the other kids down at the water hole. I want you to think about what it looks like in the country, in all the green grass and wide open spaces. I want you to think about what it looks down at the water hole, when they're down at the water hole playing. I want you to think about all this. I want you to think about what mama looks like. So I'm going to tell you this story. This is a story that I made up years ago. So I'm going to tell it to you because it's the perfect time. This story is about a young girl who lived in the country, down in the South, like Mississippi, in Alabama, Tennessee. She lived in the South, and a lot of kids that were her age and older, they would play down at the water hole. Some days it would rain so much, but when the rain stopped and the ground and the holes in the ground became filled with water, and the water hole, especially, the kids would go splashing all day in the water hole. And sometimes that water becomes so dirty that her mother would say to her, "Don't let me catch you playing in that dirty water." And the girl would be so angry with mama because she couldn't understand why all the other kids were down at the water hole playing all day and having fun, and mama would not let her go play in the dirty water. She said, "Why, mama?" Mama said, "Because there's danger in that water." She said, "You don't know what you can get into." She said, "You may get into something that could hurt you." And the girl was always afraid of being hurt, so she listened to mama. She was still angry, and she still didn't understand. She never saw the other kids hurt, but mama would not let her go and play down in that water hole. Some days she'd go down when the other kids are playing, and she'd say, "You need to come out of that water." And the kids would go, "Why?" She says, "There's danger in that water." "How do you know that?" "My mama told me." And this one little girl, oh, she could be so mean. She said, "Your mama don't know anything. What do your mama know? She don't even play in the water." And the girl would be so upset because she'd said something bad about her mama. She didn't even know her mama. And her mama was right. Her mom did tell her the right things to do. Perhaps, maybe not this time. So she decided that very early the next morning, when everyone was asleep and no one was down at the water hole, she'd go down. So she climbed out of bed, still wearing her nightgown, and she goes down to the water hole. She sneaks down the hill to the water hole. She lifts her nightgown right above her knees and ties a knot so that there'll be no evidence of her playing in this dirty water when mama gets ready to wash her clothes. And she stepped down into the water, and the water felt so good. on her legs. It was so nice and warm, and she began to dance. She twirled around, sometimes looking back at that hill where Mama was, and just teasing Mama like, nah, 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 nah. You were wrong, Mama. And she continued to dance and dance. It seemed like she danced for eternity. But all of a sudden, something made its way up through that squishy mud where she was dancing in, and it found its way to the bottom of her bare feet. And it pierced a hole through her foot, and that was a pain that she had never felt before in her life. And she screamed, Mama! Blood poured from the bottom of her foot. There was a deep cut. Something had made its way through the surface of that mud and cut her foot. And Mama was up. I'm sure she was cooking breakfast or folding the clothes or doing something. Mamas are always working. Mama knew that voice because mamas knows the voices of their children. When my kids are outside, I can tell who's who. Oh, that's Daniel's voice. Wonder what's going on with him. Mama heard her baby calling her and she ran down that hill. There was her baby standing. She had climbed out of that water hole with blood pouring out the bottom of her foot. And Mama said, what have you done?
She said, I was playing in dirty water, Mama.
Mama said, what did I tell you about playing in this dirty water?
She said, you told me that it could hurt me.
She was learning a lesson right there in that moment that just because you can't see it doesn't mean that it's not hurting you. Sort of kind of like what we're going through today, and that's why we put on our mask and our gloves on our hands to make sure that whatever we can't see is not going to harm us. So we're going to listen to the instructions and do the best thing that we can do, even though it's boring, even though it's tiresome, even though you see people out and you want to go out and have fun too. You're going to be wise, and you're going to be smart, and you're going to listen. You're going to be obedient to Mom or Dad or whoever, and do exactly what you're supposed to do to keep you safe. You know what Mama did to that baby? Mama picked that baby up in her arms and she carried her daughter up the hill to fresh, clean water. She took out the water hole and she washed that dirt all out of her daughter's cut. And she saw that that cut was not really bad enough that she had to take her to the hospital. But Mama was real good at taking care of things on her own, especially in the South. So Mama bandaged that thing up really good when she cleaned it out, and the girl was okay. She knew that she would heal, but it could have been worse. And she thought about that. And so the very next day when those kids were down there playing in that water hole again, she limped down there to that water hole and she says, hey, you all need to come out of that water. And that same little girl, why? She said, because there is danger in that water. Oh, don't tell me your mama told us to stay out of the water. She was like, no, I was hurt. And she took that bandage off her foot just for a little bit. And she stuck her foot out to those kids. And she showed the kids that wound in the bottom of her foot. And those kids got so afraid they jetted out of that water. They came flying out of that water because they knew that she was telling the truth. All but that one girl, because sometimes kids just won't listen and they suffer because of that. And she continued to play, and all the other kids stayed out of the water hole. just like the little girl had warned them. Then, just before dawn, when everything was quiet and all the kids were going home for dinner, you could hear a loud cry. Mama! And everyone knew who it was. It was the little girl. Yes, something had pierced its way up through that mud and found its way in the bottom of her foot. And she was hurt also. And she also learned that day, listen. Listen when people give you rules to follow, because you're in place for a reason. And when they show you proof that things are happening, you really have to listen. So this story is not just for kids, because it's for grown-ups too, because we sometimes don't listen either. And sometimes it takes stories like this to teach us. So that's Miss Sophie's story. It's called Dirty Water. I hope you enjoyed that story. I hope you thought about what the little girl looked like. She kind of looks like a brown-skinned girl with pigtails to me. And the mama looks very strong and beautiful with her hair pinned and maybe a scarf. And the water hole, I can see trees and the wind blowing and all the kids having a really great time. And I can't wait to have a great time with you again. This is Miss Sophie. I'm signing off for now. I'm going to come back later and we're going to make those butterflies for our butterfly story. Love you. Missing you. I can't wait to see you again. Sophie found her remote. I'm going to see if it works. Bye-bye.